When it comes to filmmaking, there's one major thing that could ruin your film no matter how beautiful your visuals look. That's bad audio.
If we switch over to the shotgun microphone that's on my camera right now, it sounds pretty bad and I wouldn't expect you to stick around and watch this entire video if this is what my audio sounded like.
Now, if you find yourself sometimes on sets where your budgets are a little bit smaller, where it doesn't make sense to hire a sound guy and you want to get the best type of audio possible in camera or through a recorder, this recorder is one of my favorite, and that's the Zoom F3. I really think that the Zoom F3 and its 32-bit float audio is perfect for you, and here's why. 32-bit float allows you to recover any clipped audio or increase the dB of your audio if it was recorded too low. Most of the time, if you're using 16-bit or any other type of audio recording, you're not going to be able to recover clipped audio or something that's so low. As you expand the waveform in your NLE, you're going to be introducing a ton of noise, especially if you didn't grab a sound print. Now, disclaimer, I'm by far not a sound engineer or an audio guy, but I have some decent experience with post-processing when it comes to EQing, dynamics, and so on. But for someone like me, I want to get the best sounding audio recorded to a recorder or in camera from the jump. Just like nailing your exposure is crucial to how hard you could push or pull a color grade, it's very important for your post-processing to nail your audio in your recorder or in camera. I really think the Zoom F3 is the best set it and forget it type of audio recorder if your strengths aren't in audio. The audio that you're hearing right now is actually using the Zoom F3 paired with a Sennheiser MKE 416 shotgun microphone. I have it boomed overhead about 6 to 8 inches away from my mouth, just out of frame. And for continuity purposes, all I did was adjust the dB levels. There has been no post-processing whatsoever done to this audio. When you're using the Zoom F3, there's not many controls like other recorders like the H4N or 6N or something like that. You don't even have a decibel meter. You're literally looking at two different channels, which this audio recorder can only record at the same time with, but you're seeing an image. The image is a waveform though. There's no dB levels, there's no gain adjustments, there's literally nothing but a plus and minus button per channel and a picture that just shows a waveform. And depending on how stretched out or narrow your waveform is what you're gonna be recording internally to it. Now, if you're super lazy, you could just hit record and then in post adjust it, but I suggest going in and hitting the plus or minus after doing some sound tests with some headphones on, and more or less just have your waveform stretched enough where it's not clipping on the top, and then you're set. Just dial it back ever so slightly, and now in post, we can adjust it. So I'm gonna show you guys fully clipped audio. You're gonna see a waveform on my NLE completely clipped. It's gonna sound atrocious, and then I'm gonna show you what's almost like sorcery in my eyes, because you literally just pull it back in seconds and now nothing's spiking, nothing's clipping, and you have usable audio. Now, for someone like me who's not so in depth when it comes to my audio and I need to do something like overhead for this YouTube video or interviews on one of my productions where it just doesn't make sense to have an audio guy and pay him his rate when I could just literally record the audio myself, I really think this Zoom F3 or any 32-bit recorder is a game changer. Now, before I demonstrate how it is that we can recover our audio, like I said, it literally takes 2 seconds. You can either skip ahead and in the description, find the timestamp where I show that, or you could stick around and we could just go over the aesthetics of this recorder if that's something that you're interested in. When it comes to the size and weight of the Zoom F3, it's a very small, compact size, but don't let that fool you because the weight feels nice and dense. This lets me know that if I was to drop it, there's a really good chance that nothing's gonna break. It feels premium, it has a good build quality, it's a mixture of metal and plastic, but that being said, most of the Zoom recorders are the same. On the back side, there's two bars that you could feed in something like a Velcro strap or bongo tie, which you could then wrap around your C stand that has the boom pole attached to it, so everything's nice and clean. Underneath there's also a quarter 20 thread if you want to rig it onto like say a camera cage like the FX6 behind me. To power the recorder, it's super simple. You have two AA batteries and they even include two, but you could throw those out because they lasted me like an hour and a half. I suggest going on Amazon and grabbing some rechargeable batteries. They're super cheap these days and definitely are gonna last a lot longer, and you can use them for other things as well. Another way to power this device, unfortunately, isn't with a DC input, but something like a USB Type-C. I feel like a lot of things are moving to Type-C just because we all have these cables lying around now, and with a power bank, you could just plug it in and let her run and do your own thing. The recorder also has the ability to do phantom power, which I'm running with my shotgun mic above head, but just remember the recommended up to 8 hours per set of batteries is gonna decrease when you're running phantom power. That additional power that's feeding into your microphone and powering it is going to be draining some more power, but from other peers on YouTube and their tests, they claim to get anywhere from 6 hours and 40 to 50 minutes runtime. So you're literally losing an hour to run phantom power. To me, that's not that bad of a trade-off. Now, taking a closer look at the Zoom F3's body, we notice two locking XLR inputs. So if you need to use a 3.5mm jack or like a 1/4-inch input, you're gonna need to buy some cheap adapters. I know other recorders have the 1/4-inch inputs built in with the XLRs, and there's sometimes 1 or 2 3.5mm jacks. Unfortunately, this recorder isn't that capable. We don't have a ton of different channels, we just get 2. So that's why this recorder does have some limitations, but if you find yourself only needing 2 different audio tracks, this thing's great. Now, continuing to look at the body, we have our line out, we have our headphone jack and the volume for that headphone. We have micro SD card slots where all your recorded audio is gonna be going onto. We have a Bluetooth module port for app control if that's something you wanna say from a distance, adjust your audio. But like I said, this thing, you literally just set it and forget it. So I don't know why spending that, I think it's like only 50 bucks would matter, because to my knowledge, you can't monitor the waveform on the app. So in my eyes, it's kind of pointless. You also have your stop, your play, pause buttons. You have your audio waveform adjustment buttons. And lastly, a menu button, and that's it. And the menu's pretty straightforward. Like I said, there's no real decibel control. There's no real metering on this besides looking at this simple picture. And that's why I think if your strength isn't in audio, but you want to get clean, crispy audio, the F3 is for you. So now that we got the aesthetics of the recorder out of the way and a little bit of info on what it does, let me show you in DaVinci completely wrecked audio. I'm gonna show you some clips that have literally the tiniest little waveform and how we could bring that back to life. And then you're gonna hear some really bad audio clipping like crazy and how we could pull it back and not have to worry about any loud peaking or unusable audio. So as promised, we're in my NLE of preference, which is DaVinci Resolve, which really doesn't matter because whether you're in Adobe Audition, Adobe Premiere, Final Cut Pro, whatever NLE or editing software you're using, you're gonna be able to make these adjustments. And like I said, it takes 2 seconds. Now, one quick thing I want to mention is, however, this recorder, you could set it and forget it, but that doesn't mean to not monitor the audio for discrepancies. So like if you're in a studio in the city and there's sirens passing by and you're doing an interview, it doesn't mean that you shouldn't be monitoring your audio. What it means is that once you have the waveform lined up where you want it, you should have everything going on. The only thing you'd have to listen to is like exterior sounds that you don't want in your audio recording. Now that we got that out of the way, we're looking at 2 different audio tracks. The one on the left, clearly clipping. The one on the right, barely non-existent. I had to expand, I guess, audio channel just to see what it's looking like. So for the sake of your eardrums, I'm not gonna play the clipped audio just because I don't want you guys going deaf. What I'm gonna do is mute the audio, and then we're gonna pay attention to this meter right here. And as I play it back, clearly she's redlining out. She's clipping. I mean, it sounds bad, it's muffled, it's clipped, you could barely make out what I'm saying. But if I go and pull back the gain, drop the decibel levels, and like I said, you could do this in any software, we're just gonna pull back. And now when we pull back, and we play the audio back, how does it sound? This is an audio test using Zoom's F3 audio recorder and its 32-bit float paired with the Sennheiser MKE416 microphone. The waveform is clipping. How does it sound after we bring it back in post? Sounds really good. Now, because we have all these peaks and valleys for you like more audio inclined guys, now you could go in and do your normalizing so everything's pretty much flatlined out the proper way. You could do your EQs, your dynamics, anything else that you want to do. Let's take a look at the one that barely is noticeable, and I'll play this one back for you. We're about negative 30 decibels, maybe negative 35. We can't hear anything at all. And normally when you would go ahead and bring these levels up, you're gonna be introducing a ton of noise. And if you didn't take a sound print, when you do your noise reduction, it's gonna sound muffled because it's gonna be working as hard as it can, and it's gonna sound like garbage. So let's take this level and bring it up and stretch it out and then play it back. How does it sound? Let's see. This is an audio test using Zoom's F3 audio recorder and its 32-bit float, paired with the Sennheiser MKE416 microphone. The waveform is extremely small. How does it sound when we bring it back in post? Now, I know my P's were a little bit harsh. I didn't have a pop filter on. I was pretty much just talking directly into the microphone. Besides that, everything is usable. There's no noise, there's no hissing, there's nothing we need to do besides process the audio to our liking. So that wraps up today's video on the Zoom F3 audio recorder and why I think a lot of you filmmakers should consider having this in your kit. Like I said, it's not for every situation, but for most of them that I find myself at least on, it works just great. So let me know in the comments below what audio recorder you're using and why, and if you saw some value in this video, please leave a thumbs up. Helping engage on this video allows this video to get seen by others, which overall allows me to create more videos, because as this channel grows, it keeps me wanting to continue these type of videos. I'm gonna leave some other videos that you might wanna check out up here on the screen, and until next time guys, I'm Jason Anthony, peace out.